Today I'm going to show you how you can turn your regular electric underfloor heating system into something smarter, something that can be controlled from an app on your phone and even connected to the rest of your smart home. I'm going to try and install this, the Ketotek Smart Wi-Fi Thermostat. In my conservatory, I have a 1.5 kilowatt electric underfloor heating system installed. It's totally isolated from the heating system in the rest of my home, and that means that if I want to turn it on to warm it up, I have to walk into that room and use the thermostat on the wall. That's like effort. It's also quite easy to leave on accidentally because it's quite a slow system to heat up. So if you're not careful, then you can rack up a hefty bill. I did originally have it wired into my Honeywell Evo home system as an electric heating zone, and I used a Honeywell relay to control the power to it. But I will eventually be moving away from Evo Home, so it's time to make the underfloor heating system in that room a little bit smarter. That's where the Ketotek Smart Wi-Fi thermostat comes in. In theory, this should just be a straight swap for my existing thermostat. The old thermostat has a temperature probe that sits under the floor tiles to help regulate the temperature, and this new one has the same type of probe too. Here's the thermostat close-up. I've still got the protective film on the display and I'm going to leave that on there until I've finished installing it, because I'm quite likely to scratch it otherwise. The buttons are all touch sensitive, so no physical click buttons here. I'd prefer physical buttons to these capacitive ones personally, but it's not a showstopper. They sell it in black too, but white I think will look a lot better in my conservatory. If I turn it over, all of the terminals are usefully numbered. 1 and 2 will connect to the underfloor heating elements themselves. 3 and 4 are the incoming power supply, and 5 and 6 will connect to the temperature sensor probe. I'm recording this part of the video before I've actually fitted the thermostat, obviously, otherwise this would be bolted to my wall right now. I've no idea whether this will be a success or not, so please join me in the conservatory where I'm going to have a go at installing it. Well, here I am in the conservatory, and this is the thermostat that I'm going to be swapping out today. This one here is actually the old battery-powered Evo Home thermostat. I'm going to leave it where it is because I don't want to fill in any holes in the wall today. I've turned the power off, so hopefully I won't electrocute myself. I'm going to fast forward this whole process up for you, but you can watch me hopefully survive this. That was a lot more effort than I thought it was going to be, but it's on the wall. I'm going to turn the power on. I'll leave the camera rolling just in case it catches something exploding. Well, nothing went bang, and there's something on the display. Go. It's working. 9.5 degrees. I guess I better power it on. So we've got a power button, turning it on and off. You can see it's not got Wi-Fi connected yet. It says it's 9.5 degrees in here, and I can set the temperature, the set point. I'm going to set it to 20 at the moment, and I think what I'll do is I'm going to leave this for 15-20 minutes, make sure it's okay, and then see if I can set up the smart part. Here's something that might be useful for you. If you want to use the underfloor temperature probe, you actually have to configure it to use that. I had to read the manual to figure it out. I just wanted to know if it was working or not. You've got the option of using the built-in temperature sensor on the wall. You can use the underfloor probe, or you can use both of them together. What you do is you power it off, you hold down the OK button for 3 seconds, and it will say BN on the screen. And at the moment, I've got it set to N2, which is the underfloor temperature. N3 is both, and N1 is just the temperature sensor in this unit. If I set it to N2, so as I can see what the temperature sensor is doing under the floor, I then press OK and turn it back on. And the little picture of a heating mat actually has a temperature probe symbol next to it. That's been about half an hour now, and it's definitely working. It's drawing power. No breakers have tripped. The floor is starting to get warm. I mean, it's pretty cold today, as you can see, 10 degrees now. So it would take quite a while for this floor to heat up. What I'm going to do now is try and connect it to the Tuya app. Apparently what I need to do is tap on the add button, add device, and then I hold down set and OK until the Wi-Fi symbol starts to flash. It's not doing anything yet. Just try it again. There we go, pairing. Discovering devices, add. Yeah, manual input, Wi-Fi name. Being added. Not very interesting to watch this bit. I'll fast forward until we get to something interesting. Added successfully. Done. What have we got? Current set point 10 degrees, current temperature 10 degrees. So can I power it off? Yep. I can hear a relay click and it actually powers off. If I power it on, relay's clicking again. Heating's coming on. That's pretty good. Let's change the set point. 19 degrees. Oh, that is good. You can actually see all of the different temperature sensors and all the settings inside that you'd have to access through the special menus manually. So if I just put in the password here, I'm gonna do 3456. It's nice that it gives you the password. Save it. Internal and external sensors. So that little bit I showed you before about setting the which temperature sensor you want to use, you don't have to go through that routine. You can just do it through the app. That is really good. Right, back to the studio. I know that I said it took me a little longer than I expected to install it, but that wasn't the thermostat's fault. The electrician who fitted the old thermostat didn't leave me much slack on the wires, so I had to extend a couple of them so as I could actually get the cables in place. There's been a bit of a jump in time since I did the installation because I wanted to make sure that I was happy with it and that it was all working fine before I finished making this video. But for the sake of continuity, I am still wearing the same clothes. Since then, I have added it to Home Assistant, which you can do via the Tuya cloud integration or using LocalTuya. If you are using LocalTuya, then on the screen now you should see the data points you need to configure it properly. I'll also put them in the description too for you. The thermostat itself can be programmed on a daily schedule with 6 set points during each day. Or you can set a 5+2 schedule so as the weekends are different to the weekdays, or a 6+1 schedule. Personally though, I stuck the thing in manual mode only and I use Home Assistant to control it. This time of year, the conservatory struggles with damp and mould, so I've created an automation to turn it on during my off-peak energy hours a couple of times a week, so hopefully that should keep the mould away. You can, of course, connect it to your favourite voice assistant too, as long as those are either from Amazon or Google. This is done using the Tuya app, but if you want to control it using Siri, then you can use Home Assistant to easily publish the device to HomeKit. I'll put a link to the thermostat in the description so as you can go and check it out for yourself. Anyway, I hope you found this useful, and if you did, then please give the video a like, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel to see more videos from me. Thank you for watching, goodbye.